Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Final Fantasy Tactics Rebirth. Ramza, still not quite where he needs to be in order to get Fly. Rad, I didn't do anything with him either. Alicia, still getting job points. Lavian, I gave her... I bought all the different dances, and then I took a save. I know I said before that I don't see this being terribly useful, but since we're maxing out the job anyway, it seemed more useful than either of these skills, or Brave Up. And the reason why I considered it to be better than Brave Up is because you'll see that a save is triggered on HP damage, whereas Brave Up is only triggered on physical attacks, so a save is going to trigger far more often than Brave Up. I also took charge plus 6 with my archer here, with Redford, and I also equipped him with some spike shoes. He didn't have an accessory before because I took it off. And I gave him a Stadio game JP up. Not really going to be an issue going forward. So let's go ahead and do this battle. I thought this scene was really cool as a kid. It's the way the city looks with the sunset, and the music is quite nice too. I don't think it plays very often in the game. I'm not sure if this is the only time it plays in the game. It may play at the fur trader, but I can't remember if that's right. Yes, yes. Let's meet up in the slums when we're hunting down a criminal organization. Because, you know, criminal organizations never hang out in slums. I should mention that is also one of the few times in the game where you actually visit like a city center that and you're not in a battle. So kind of interesting. It doesn't seem like there's really anything much for us to buy here. Oh, I should buy a few of these. Options are fine. Oh yeah, I did use a Phoenix Down last battle, so Phoenix Downs. Stuff's fine. Don't have any better guns or bows. Interesting here. Oh, okay. Oh, sorry, I actually already read that. Never mind then. So, let's get out. Oh, is this a battle? Alright, I can't remember exactly what the disposition of troops is like in, this map. I do remember that we're somewhat far away from the enemy. That's about it. There. And I know we're going to be at an elevation disadvantage, but I can't remember exactly what kind of situation we're in. I like most of the sprites in this game, but Breedvich's sprite is just a little bit weird looking. I like his portrait though. Breedvich is also after the Holy Stone. Well, actually, we already knew that. Collaborating all along. That wasn't foreshadowed at all. Seems like that is the case. Alright, so we've got archers, thieves, and summoners. First gonna go with Nameless Pants, but I'm shortly gonna switch out to Witch Hunt so I can cut out their MP. And I think I will stand here so as to reduce the chance of archers hitting me. I see Mustadio doesn't have a weapon because he was held captive. I guess that's why he has equip change normally. Usually take equip change off because it's for the most part totally useless. I wonder if Rams is gonna get killed here. Thieves and archers have the highest speed in the game, so it's not such a good thing for him. If he does die, then yeah, I'm gonna use the Geomancer to bring him back to life. Run away! Yeah, so somebody in the Something Awful forums mentioned that I had the speed system in this game a little bit wrong. Or rather, quite a bit wrong. Essentially, there are like three categories of time events in the game. And they all rely on one system of ticks. So each tick of time will add to the character's progression in the AT order, and also it will progress any casting time. And finally, it will also contribute to status effects wearing off. But all of those categories operate independently from another, and the only one that is affected by speed is the AT. So the casting time and the speed at which a status effect wear off are not affected by speed or by haste or whatever you want to use. So what this means is that casting times are constant. I don't know if it's even going to be worth doing that. Casting times are constant, but the speed at which characters act increases gradually throughout the game. So that means that spells and other abilities that use casting time are more effective or more powerful at the beginning of the game than they are at the end. And in short, what that means is that my party is going to get progressively weaker relative to, say, a party that is made up of knights or other melee characters as the game goes on. So yeah, I kind of anticipated that the difficulty in this game has like a kind of inverted bell curve shape, right? It starts out fairly difficult, it gets quite a bit easier around Act 2, and then it's going to continue to get more difficult as we get towards the end of the game. At least that's what I expect. Make sure that those summoners aren't really able to do much. So yeah, the dances, like spells, have their own casting times, and that is why haste does not improve the effectiveness of dances, contrary to what I said before. Let's look at these casters. Yeah, they're both at 12 MP, so I think only skills they'd probably be able to use would be like Google. Oh, I can't look at their spells. Okay, that's reasonable. Thank you. Arius. He's going to attack. I'm going to attack him straight up like this, and then hopefully the poison will kill him. So the summoners are entirely out of mana at this point. They're basically taken out of the equation. Bring Ramza back to life again. I'm just being really cautious about this because I'd hate to lose the mission when my Geomancer, say, gets killed, and then that gets followed up by Ramza turning into a crystal, or just, you know, dying. He doesn't actually turn into a crystal, he's in the kill state for the game. Yeah, I think this may be a case where I just want to use his black magic and try to kill some characters instead of using... Okay, I'll do this. Hopefully it'll be destructive in some way. Okay, this is not useful in any way anymore. Sure, it's getting her job points, but we really could be doing something more constructive. Alright. Just a little bit too late with that. Could have possibly brought him back to life. Or sorry, well, giving him re-raise, and then after giving him re-raise, when he got killed, I could have brought him back to life. So the only character we're really concerned about is this archer. Hitter of that. I think I'm just gonna go all out. As long as. Yep. Fine. That's even better. Make sure that that thief dies because of the poison. I wonder if he's gonna kill my summoner. Oh. Oh, interesting. You see, the poison does a percentage of your life, so I expected that to kill him, but instead we got finished off by the dancer. Yeah, I'd like to master the dancer job as fast as I possibly can, so that I can then move her over to being maybe a samurai, so I can get equipped knife, and then we'll have a sweet dancer character with a katana. How cool is that? The point of that being to increase the damage of Wizen Abyss. And I guess maybe also the damage of the MP, anti-MP attack, because it seems to do the same amount of damage in MP that Wizen Abyss does in HP. Okay. So that's that. Just keep on doing what you're doing. You can kill this frog. I don't think Rams is going to be able to punch this guy to death, so... let's try the fashion way. Dead, Mr. Frog. Will his father be all right? Yeah, I mentioned in this, in the last video, or maybe the one before that, that Mysterio kind of becomes irrelevant to the story once this act is complete. And actually, that's kind of characteristic of all the special characters in the game, that once you get them, they're no longer included in any of the cinematics. And I think the reason why that's the case is, well, first of all, because the writers probably wanted to maintain some degree of focus in the storyline. But also because once you get a character, you could either choose not to recruit them or choose to remove them from your roster once you have recruited them, in which case them showing up in a cinematic wouldn't make any sense. So I don't know if it was an issue with the memory of the PS1. But even the size of save files on the PS1 memory card, which were very small. But I would like to have seen them maybe just remove the ability to get rid of special characters, and that way, being able to have the characters show up again in later cinematics. Like, I would have liked to see Agrius have a more significant role in the story, even Mustadio. I mean, I think as long as you still have him in your party, he does show up in another cinematic later in the game. It's like an optional side quest. But it's very peripheral. I would have liked to see the special characters show up more in main line of the story. Not to say that the main line of the story is bad by any means, but I figure, you know, once you get a character, you would like to see them continue to participate in the plot, so that their development throughout the rest of the game isn't just in terms of stats and what you do with them in battle. Well, all hope seems lost. Or does it? Stadio's trickery. Ramza perhaps showing his first political insight in the entire game. the church is in a bid to gain secular power to take over the country and create a theocracy. Maybe not the entire church. All we know right now is that is Cardinal Draclo's ambition. But will the princess be in another castle? Alright. We're gonna add him to our party even if we don't use him. Him stick around. Maybe send him on some jobs or something. Of course, as I mentioned, we do need him for a side quest game. Alright, well, we can't go back to Zigalus Swamp, which I can't say I'm terribly distressed about. I'm just going to buy some Phoenix Downs. Fair number there. And we are going to Warjilis Trade City. This is called the Burgos Sea. Interesting. Understand why that would be the case. I mean, the only port they have, you'd be armed. Or guarded, I should say. Alright, so it's Delita. Now, this is going to maybe be the best statement of Delita's philosophy following the end of Act 1 in the entire game. Best ways don't always lead to the best results. And when he says, you can't save her, I think he must be alluding. Well, of course he's referring directly to Ovelia, but he must be alluding also to Ramza's failure to save Teta, and the failure of his methods past. Seems reasonable to think that the same flow would be the flow that has been plotted by the church. And perhaps Delita is a little bit of a double agent in all this. Has his own intentions. Yes, Ramza has an item. Do 10%. That's regen. That's confusion on hit. Nice. So I think this is the last mission we'll be using Redford in, but might as well. Not really hurting for money at this point. So that was a lot of cash, but it'll pay off. Now, as I said, I'm hoping to get equipped knife for Lavian. And the better knife here is... I don't know why they're called knives. It should be, I don't know, katana, or maybe even just call them kotetsu, but anyway. I see the weapon type is katana, but it's a little bit silly to add knife to the end of it. Anyhow, has a 25% evade chance and does 8 damage, and this one only does 7, so I will be buying one of these. And I'm also going to buy one of these. Maybe two. Just in case we want to use the ability. I really don't think we will use it much. I've found generally that katanas tend to break less when you use the samurai draw out skill in Rebirth. But nevertheless, I do want to be a little bit cautious. Just make sure. And we have an extra sitting around. Alright, Powerist, very expensive. I'm certainly glad that we grabbed one off of Gafurian. And, in fact, I think I might switch the Powerist over to my Dancer, because it's probably going to be more effective than it has been on the Geomancer, because he's very rarely been able to close with the enemy, and has mostly ended up using his Geomancy skills of actual direct attack with his attacks. I'm gonna buy one each of these, because they can occasionally be useful. And I will buy one of these. The reason why I'm doing this shopping is because we have a fair number of missions up ahead where there will be no shop available. And, last but not least, I have a gold shield. So, I think we should be able to outfit Agrius just fine, which we'll be doing in the next mission. Or rather, after the next mission, when we add her to our party. So, that will be it for today. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. And if you're wondering when I'm going to upload again, it should be tomorrow. Bye.